who's going double inside his back, double short.
Then you can close it in a little bit on him if you want, like that. Just kind of keep him centered up.
My shoulder, right into my head, right into the shoulder. I catch his wrist. Let that break it down. Alright, so I'm just equal to Tyler's angle, pump him forward. Alright, immediately, do a star ride, bring him down to that. Alright, so if I give this vision off breakdown, you know, it's easy armbar for me. A lot of times I get it off the takedown. Alright, hit the guy down, then wait for 1 second thinking, oh crap, I gotta take it down. The arm's always left here. Alright, so it's a really easy setup, simple setup. Alright, but a lot of people don't think it works because by the time they do it, the guy from here is already locked over here, so I can't get the head level. Alright, so I'm getting this right off the takedown. Take the guy down. Alright, break him down right here. Head and shoulder. Alright, come over the top, catch his wrist. Here, catch your wrist. Alright, once I do that, I want to make sure his arm's straight. So if his arm's bent a little bit, I straighten his arm out before I pull it back. Here, head and shoulder, catch your wrist, straighten his arm out. Once his arm's straight now, I'm on my toes, I'm sliding in my knee right into his armpit, right here, and I pull his arm back. Once I do that, my back leg is hitting a small step up. From here, I trap his arm, now I just trap it for 1 second, and I slide back right to my arm bar. Alright, once I get my arm bar here, I think it's very important that I keep a fist on his back. Alright, fist on his back, palm, he can't tell the difference. Alright, but when the fingers get close to the neck, right, it's potentially dangerous. You're gonna stop the match. Alright, so to keep him safe, to keep me safe and able to do the move, I keep my fist and nose back, then it keeps it legal. Alright, because I don't want to hurt the guy. Alright, so once I get the arm bar here, my fist on his back. This first one I do, I keep his elbow covered. Here, fist on his back, I'm keeping his elbow covered in my armpit. Alright, from here, taking my right hand, coming under, catching his wrist. Once I catch his wrist, I pull it to me, nice and tight. Now, from here, I'm driving his shoulder to his ear. And a lot of people jump around the head and try to sit out. I don't think that one's very successful, especially in the high school and college wrestling. So, I try to drive his shoulder to his ear. I want to finish chest to chest. Right? Fist on his back, add the wrist. Now I'm driving his shoulder through his ear. Shouldn't be any space. Drive, 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 drive. Alright, usually about halfway over. I can settle back. Finish chest to chest. And so the reason, right, a big reason why I don't jump around his head and really leave a lot of space here, because a lot of times people will sit up. Alright, it happened to us last year. I remember one of our guys wrestling on Notre Dame last year. I got an arm bar, guy set up, I got a grip. Alright, arm bar here, I start forcing it, a lot of space, I guess he sits up, so I get reversed. Alright, so it's very, very important that I'm keeping his shoulder in his ear, and I want to finish chest to chest. One more time, I have broken down, head and shoulder, catch the wrist, the up, trap, arm bar. Right hand come under, catch the wrist, pull to me, now I'm driving his shoulder through his ear. Drive, 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 settle back, finish off chest to chest, my head, and the pose. Alright, so that's what I'm always trying to get first, right? A lot of times, when I try to get his wrist, he takes his wrist away. Here comes my second one, it's also my favorite one. Alright, head and shoulder, same thing. Catch your wrist, so catch your wrist here. Alright, same setup, hold on back, knee up, trap, arm bar. This time, I come under and try to catch his wrist. Alright, I can't get it. Alright, so I'm going right to the hat. I'm under here, can't get the wrist. Right here, right to the hat. Alright, so kind of like what Coach Roselli was saying earlier, when I get my hat here, I don't just have the back of his neck. I'm all the way on the other side of his neck, so it's so tight. So no matter what he does, it doesn't matter. He's going over. Alright? If it's in the back of his neck, he can look away, he breaks my hat. Alright? I'm trying to get my hat really, really deep on the other side of his neck. Right. If it's not very tight, what I do is I want it like I did the first move, right? And he gets down, then I get it really tight. From here, his head's up, I can't get it, I start throwing him over. Right. I might use my head to push his head down, then I get the deep half. Once I get the deep half here, I jump sides to the half side. Now, right now, right, it's really, really tight here. And he's flexing, it's kind of hard to take him over. So what I do is I pull him into me, and I let his elbow slip out. Here, pull him into here. Let the elbow slip out. When I do that, I make sure I keep my fist and nose back. Right? I can see his elbow, that's what I want. Now I drive I'm going to put my elbow, my right elbow on the mat. Drive, right elbow, right hip on the mat.
Nice and tight.
Right, that one's really tight. That one's been my number one pin for the past 6, 7, 8 years. Okay, so again, head and shoulder, right? Same thing, catch the wrist, knee up the trap, arm bar. Right, kind of thinking like I'm trying to get the wrist, I can't get it. All right, I want to get the knee pad. All right, one thing I like to do is, I like to go palm up, here, get the half nice and tight. Remember, if I can't, if it's not that tight, I'll fake like I'm running the wrist. Run. If my head pushes head down, come up, get the half nice and tight. All right, from here, I jump sides. All right, my elbow's covered right now, so I pull them into me, let the elbow slip. All right, shoulders on the mat. If I can see his elbow, I'm not drive over.
Right here.
Alright, so that one's been my most successful one. So another one, alright, let's go to another setup now. Alright, so we did the spiral ride. Alright, that one comes a lot of the takedown too. Alright, another one that I do a lot is off the wrist. Alright, another setup here. Alright, so I can do spiral ride again. Spiral ride, catching his wrist here. Right now he's still a little bit on his base. So when I break him down, I roll the wrist out. Break him down to his stomach, roll the wrist out. So now he's flat on his stomach, his wrist is out here like this. Alright? Very important for me, I keep my weight on the whole time, and I want to cover his arm the whole time, alright? Because I don't want to lift his arm up, hurt him, stop him move. Alright? Keep his wrist covered the whole time. Alright, if I can put it on his back, right away, I'll do that. Alright, sometimes he's fighting really hard. So I had to sit on my hip, use two hands, pull his arm out, pull out the middle of his back. Once you're kind of the middle of his back here, I keep my chest down. All I'm doing with my chest down is switching hands. Right now my left hand has the wrist. Here, switch hands, right hand has it. Alright, now what I do is open it up, arm bar, down. Alright, now that's arm bar. That's another way to get the arm bar. Alright, another thing that's common for me, So I have the arm bar. He'll be in here nice and tight. Alright, so he's his arm in. Alright, so I'm trying to get here. I can't get the arm bar, I can't get the wrist, anything like that. Alright? One thing I'll do here, I'll take my right arm and block his arm. Alright, so the same idea as the first one, except to hold out the wrist. Alright, so his arm's in, all I do is block it. Alright, block it, get off to the arm bar side. Now I'm driving his shoulder to his ear. Drive, keep driving. Alright, get halfway over. Alright, chest. Pull the arm out. Put the hand in close. Alright, finish off your chest with your hip. So, alright, you have the arm bar. His wrist is not available. He's kind of holding it tight here, kind of stalling. Not really trying to let you turn him. Alright, just block the arm. Block the arm, run over like you normally would, shoulder in his ear. Okay? So again with that setup, right? This is probably my best setup in the last couple years. I try to get the head lever, and a lot of times people will lock their hands. Right? So I get wrist to wrist a lot, right? Roll up on their back. Again, I just fly right, catch the wrist. Roll up under, here. Right, set my hip, pull the arm out, put on the back. So this hand, my left hand has it. This hand, my right hand has the wrist. Open it up, arm bar down. Yeah. So another move. The next one from the arm bar, right? Arm bar, nice and tight, fist on his back, right hand come under and catch your wrist. Alright, once I get your wrist, I pull it through me. Alright? Sometimes I have trouble getting off to the side. Alright, turn it over here. So I'm just gonna do a tilt. Alright, so here. Alright, I'm gonna straddle. Alright, so both legs on the side here. I have a wrist. I'm all I'm gonna do is lift my chest up and I grab my own elbow. Alright, so here. I'm not really working off the side or anything. I'm in the middle. I lift my chest up. Grab my own elbow. All right, when I do that, I'm going to just push off with my left leg here. I'm taking it over his right shoulder. Push off my left leg. Take it over his right shoulder. Then I just pinch his body with my knees. Pinch like this. All right, you can put the leg in if you want. If not, that's okay. Pinch your body. All right, a lot of people make a mistake here. When they get this, they take it right over to the side. A lot of times it's going to be close to your back point, you're going to fight one, but he's not quite breaking, I think, 90 degrees. So here, side this. His foot in, it's close, or you're not getting the back points. Right? It's very important to drive it over the shoulder. The shoulder that I have his wrist, here. Foot drop, drive over the shoulder. Now you're getting the back points for sure. Just tight, like that. So again, I do not want here, arm bar. Right, we'll go wrist to wrist. Alright, roll it under, here. Put it on his back. Alright, chest on, put your chin, open up, arm bars down. Alright, this time, he's real tight again. Right? You guys know Diana Julius, right? He's got real flexible arms.
Yeah. Alright,
I need you to do a demonstration. I can take his arm all the way over here. Alright? And it doesn't affect him. Alright, so he's hard to hit arm bars on. Alright, so you wrestle those guys, they're real flexible, stuff like that. I got the arm bar here. This one works against all the flexible guys. If I take my right hand, my off hand, I got the arm bar. Go across his face, keep my palm down like this. From here, all I'm doing is circling around his head. Like this, circle. And one thing is right here, right in, top, lock, shoulder into his chest. All right, so this one works against really flexible guys. So again, down the arm bar. Here. Alright, he's kind of tucked in. Alright, I'm having trouble turning him. Take my right hand. Alright, kind of going across his face here. Keep my hand on the mat. Put this on the mat here. Now I can start to get off to the side. Circle. Alright, one thing is to roll down the back here. I can switch positions over the top. Lock. I put my shoulder into the chest. Right here, down on the mat. Alright, that's one I've been working on a lot. Alright, let's go.
Point your chair back. Just hop open the way.
Alright, so now, put the belly to the leg in. Sits up all flat. Alright, so I do one with the leg in here. Alright, so here. I just like a simple way to get the leg in. I bump him forward, pull my left leg in. Alright, now I'm going to do the short loop. I'm going to like hook it here. So we're gonna get the leg in here. Alright, drape over top of him. Before I start getting my setup from the arm bar, I take my left hand right here on the shoulder. Right hand, kind of leg, nice and tight. Alright, so he's being a good partner. He's staying up on his face. I can't really break him down. From here, taking my left hand, over top of his head. I'm gonna scoop his arm up. Alright, so again, here nice and tight, left hand over top of his head here, scooping his arm up. Alright. His arm up, then I just switch, slide my arm bar in, just like that. Again, here, nice and tight, over top, move his arm up, like that, just like you're doing a curl. You have to do it over top like this, just like you're doing a curl, curl it up, right to my arm bar. Alright, come here, once I get to my arm bar, alright, I can break him down in the stomach, break him down. But once I do that, usually I take my leg out, and I go to work in any of my other turns. What I really like to do when he stays up, I like to roll. So I like in here, scoop, here, nice and tight. So, I'm not going to break him down, that's fine. I'm going to slide under. Slide under, get the half. Once I get the half, I push off my left foot, and I roll across my back. When I roll, the leg comes out. Don't keep the leg up. Don't be tight, and it won't go up to your hips up. His legs should come out pretty easily. Got the half here, I push off, pull across my back, leg comes out, pop the hips. Jump five, right there, close the hands. So this one also works when you're on the mat. Flatten out. We got the arm bar over here. Right, got the half. Right, I'm trying to run it over. You can just fight it down really hard. Can't get it. All right, so what I have to do if I want to do it from the mat, I want to get him on my knee. Alright? So I gotta lift him up and put him on my knee. He's on the inside of the stomach. It's hard for me to roll him. So I gotta get a little space. Here, arm bar, half. Alright, I try to get it, can't get it, lift him up on my knee. Once he's here on my knee here, I got the space. Alright, my hips are under. Now it's pretty easy. Roll across my back, pop my hips. Sometimes I get his arm bar, I'm trying to roll, maybe I roll once, and I can't get him, easy. You feel really tight. Not, I can't take it over. I can't roll. Right?
Flatten out here like this.
I'm having a hard time. I can't even
come over like that.
Right. One thing I like to do is take my hands, all right, my left hand, go one-on-one over top like this. Right. Once I get to here, all right, keep that nice and tight. Take my right hand, go over top of his head. All right, go two-on-one. All right, left hand over, right hand under. All right, and my elbow right here in his shoulder. All right, step up, elbow in his shoulder, lift up on his arm. Lift up on his arm here. Thank you guys very much.